Hi, and welcome to the second Mixstory episode. This time you will follow our guide Pranay on the epic and perilous ascension of Mount Everest. We are taking the bus and we will see the southern route starting after the village of Lukla in Nepal. You will discover along the way the four main camps settled for climbers to the world famous summit. Enjoy the journey.
Here we are in base camp at 5,100 meters, where all the logistics, Sherpa guides, and kitchen tents are settled. The surface is rocky and uneven. Right now, it's snowing. We can't see Everest at all. Every morning here starts with a much welcomed hot cup of tea or coffee, prepared by the cook boy before sunrise. We're finalizing the last preparations and heading toward the icefall, one of the most dangerous stages of the South Col route. Before that trek, we all participate into what is called the puja ceremony, which consists of asking the gods for good fortune for the Sherpas and the climbers as they attempt to summit the mountain. All the critical climbing equipment is blessed: harnesses, crampons, ice axes, and helmets, as well as the expedition flag. Now it's time to start the expedition. can now see the Khumbu Icefall in front of us. It's both a very frightening yet beautiful place. It is very early in the morning and still dark here, but this is actually the best time to travel through the icefall. Once the sun is up, this becomes a very dangerous place. The whole glacier is extremely unstable, and I can tell that it is not a place you want to hang around in. The icefall is made of huge chunks of moving ice, some the size of a house. There are many deep, dark crevices that we need to cross by the means of one or more ladders. There are countless scary things that can happen here. I'm trying to focus on each step over the void. Hope the worst is now done. We are arriving now at Camp 1, also known as the Valley of Silence. This is a vast, flat area of endless snow, deep crevices, and mountain walls frequently washed by avalanches. That's where we are setting up the camp. At night, we listen to the deep, murmuring, cracking sounds under our tents. It is the crevices opening and closing deep down in the glacier beneath. You keep your fingers crossed that it won't happen right under your tent.
You are my bones.
Up and I've started walking in the valley of silence towards the next camp. And after just a few steps around a corner, we finally have the first close sight of Everest. But we still have a long and exhausting hike to go. The wind is extremely strong. When it kicks up, we have to stand still and wait. After an endless slow march through the silent valley, you reach at last a rocky patch at the foot of the icy Lhotse wall. This is Camp 2. This place is absolutely stunning. Clouds roll in from the lower ranges of the Himalayas, up the valley and into the camp. It's time for a recovering night of sleep and a warm meal before the next hike to Camp 3.
Quiet.
Forces me to breathe deeper and faster, thus saturating my body with more oxygen. Like most of the mountaineers, we start using oxygen masks over 7,000 meters until Camp 3. Slip and I'm possibly gone. Focus. death zone. This moonscape is at the edge of the atmosphere, and the sky owns a strange dark blue color. It is surely the closest you can get to space on Earth. My teammates don't talk a lot. Only fear remains on everyone's faces. We all know the stories related to this damned area. In a couple of hours, we will start to put on our gear for the final part of the adventure, the summit push. The wall towards the summit is steep and dark. We are in the dead zone, and I can't help thinking that within the next 48 hours, there is a very real risk that we might not live. Summit at 8,800 meters, a bit less than 29,000 feet. The temperature here is around minus 40 degrees Celsius. time spent on the summit cannot exceed 20 minutes. I'm now looking at one of the most fantastic scenes of my life.